Okay, Michael, so here's a quick quiz. So we just tried to argue that boosting has this annoying habit of not always overfitting, but of course, something can always overfit because otherwise we just do boosting and we're done, and then neither of us would have jobs, and we don't want that to happen. So here's a little quiz to see if we can figure out the circumstances under which boosting might overfit or tends to overfit. So here are five possibilities. Let me read them to you. Tell me if they actually make sense. So here's possibility number one. Boosting will tend to overfit if the weak learner that it's boosting over always chooses the weakest output. That is, among all the hypotheses that it finds that do better than chance over the training data with whatever given distribution, it will always pick the one that is still nonetheless closest to chance while still being better.
Well, why would it do that?
Just to be difficult.
All right. And so you want to know whether that makes it over, will tend to make it overfit.
Will tend to make boosting overfit, yes.
Okay. All right.
Okay. The second one is a weak learner actually ends up using, or the weak learner itself that boosting is using is in fact a neural network learner. And just for a little specificity, let's say this is a neural network that has many, many layers and many, many nodes. So, it's a big, powerful neural network. All right. The other option is boosting has a lot of data. So you're trying to learn, your training data is actually very, very, very large. You have lots and lots of examples. The fourth case is that the true underlying hypothesis, the true underlying concept is in fact nonlinear. So you can't just draw a line. And then the fifth case is that we let boosting train much too long, whatever that means. Let's just say we let it train a lot, not just 1,000 iterations, but 100 billion iterations.
Okay.
Okay? Billions and billions of iterations. Okay, you got it?
Yeah.
All right, go.